Oh my gosh, yeah. My family goes to that carnival every year. It's only open for about a week in November, but we go like every day it's open. It's sort of like a family tradition, but you guys should totally come with me this year.
Well, when does it open?
This year, I think it's the 18th of November.
Ugh, that's like a month. We should like sneak in. What? Like a little Halloween adventure.
A carnival at night would be epic. We'd probably get caught by workers or guards. I wouldn't think so. It's just a little pop-up carnival. They wouldn't have night guards while the place is empty, plus the workers only seem to be there in the daytime.
I don't know. I mean, why not? Your teenagers are the best time to do stupid things. The worst we'll do is get grounded. They're not gonna, like, charge us.
Timothy, you think there would be no charge for breaking and entering? That seems extremely unlikely, I'm sorry. We're just a bunch of stupid kids approaching Halloween. It's super common to do stuff like this. We'll be fine.
Stupid kids can be charged with things too. It's called juvie.
It's not like we're going there to vandalize stuff. We'll be fine. I can't believe I'm telling you guys this, but, I'm not proud of this, but my family knows a way to get in. We've been going there for such a long time now, we sort of know all the ins and outs. The fences don't fully connect in one area and just has a chain link. We could definitely squeeze through.
Wait, Violet, you're in on this just like that?
Well, I mean, Timothy does have a point. The workers only stay during the night when the carnival is actually open. My grandpa works there every year, so he isn't wrong.
Dang, Violet. So much for your goody two-shoes image.
Well, hey, a girl needs some adventure every so often. The only other event I have coming up is Halloween, and we're too old to trick or treat, so we have to find some fun. And let me tell you, I am tired of handing out treats. I mean, I'm still gonna have to, but at least it's something to look forward to in between.
What? You don't trick or treat anymore? I go every year.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean it like that. I just mean I at least feel too old. There's nothing wrong with getting free candy, though.
Even if we do go, how are we gonna get out? Your mom will definitely hear the garage open if we drive, and I doubt she'll let Isaac and Timothy stay the night.
Yeah, I don't really know, to be honest. Actually, my parents don't care if I have girls stay over. Since I'm walking distance from the fair, maybe just like, Violet, say you're staying at Nancy's, and Nancy, say you're staying at Violet's. Simple. It's one of the oldest tricks in the book, but they wouldn't have any reason to question it.
Yeah, that could work. Are we doing this tonight, though? Shouldn't we, like, prepare?
There's nothing really to prepare for. It's just gonna be carnival rides and games that aren't even turned on. It's basically just gonna be taking a walk if you think about it.
Sounds kinda lame when you put it like that.
More lame than us all going home and doing nothing? If everyone's in, I guess I'll let my mom know that you two are going home and that I'm heading over to Nancy's. But if I am caught, you are all dead. Hey, you joined in on the idea all on your own. We didn't even try to convince you. Yes, you did, but whatever. Let's just not be too stupid. I just want to do more than sit around. It's killing me.
You two should probably head home now so it doesn't get too late. And Isaac, go over to Timothy's, obviously, and Nancy and I will be there in about an hour or so.
I like this new Violet.
Don't get used to it. This is a one-time thing due to extreme boredom.
Hey, Mom. Is it cool if I stay over at Nancy's tonight? Her mom is making dinner and we're watching a super good show.
Of course, sweetie. What show?
We're watching Popular.
Really? I loved that show.
I didn't take you much for the romance drama type.
Well, I'm gonna head to bed soon, so just call me if you need me. Have fun, girls. Love ya.
Awesome. Thanks, Mom. I love you. Night.
Sweet. I guess I'll walk you guys out then.
They're going so soon? I was just about to start dinner.
Oh, I'm sorry, ma'am. If you're already done, we can eat. Don't want it to go to waste.
No worries. I haven't started yet.
I'll just make enough for the four of us, if your father even stops watching the football game.
Well, ma'am, thank you for having us.
See ya.
They're taking ages. Maybe they couldn't come since they were gonna use the same dinner excuse for Nancy's place too.
Nah, they would've called. Plus, it wouldn't make sense why they'd leave Violet's house to have a second dinner at Nancy's anyway.
It's not really a huge deal, I guess.
We can always do it another time.
Yeah, but I'm pumped. I don't know if I'll have the courage to do this again.
Or Violet. I'm still shocked that she agreed so fast.
To be honest, the recommendation was more of a joke, but it could still be fun. Even if we were caught, I don't think much will happen. Who arrests teenagers unless they committed a serious crime?
I mean, it really depends, but I think we'll be alright. Like I said earlier, I drive by it almost every day, and I only see cars and trucks during daylight. And I highly doubt potential guards are just, like, walking to their shift every day. It's a tiny pop-up carnival, not Disneyland.
Mom, I know it's kinda late to ask, but is it fine if I stay at Nancy's tonight? She just got a new PS5 game and I wanna check it out.
Normally I would say yes, but it's already after dinner time. Don't you think it's kind of late to spring this on her parents?
Please, I can't get it on mine because I have the PS3, not even the 4. I'm grateful for it, of course, it just, I can't play this game.
Alright, but I have to call her parents. Well, she must be asleep. I'm sorry, girls, I wouldn't feel right to...
Actually, I asked my mom this morning, I just forgot to let you know.
Well, why didn't you say something before I called?
I was, chewing.
Well, as long as she's aware. Want me to drive you girls?
No, it's okay, Mom. We can take my car. I didn't get a license for nothing.
I am so sorry we're so late. My mom made dinner later than usual, so thank you so much for letting us come on such late notice.
Oh, of course. Just don't stay up too late.
Your dad is so chill. He didn't call our parents to confirm or anything.
I never really get into trouble, so I guess he's just not too hard on me.
You not getting in trouble? That's surprising.
Hey!
So, what shall we do in the meantime? It's only 9:30, so it's way too early to go.
No duh, it's too early. You guys just got here. My dad is clearly still awake.
I know, doofus. I'm just asking what we should do for now.
Well, we were about to play GTA because we weren't sure if you two were showing up, but we could all play and just switch off, I guess.
Thank you, but that's not really my style.
Of course it's not. Figures. I do have Smash Bros, though, if that's better. It's Nintendo, so...
I'm awful at that, so I'll basically just be button mashing the whole time, but it's still a time passer. I guess get it out.
Hell yeah.
Alright, so they're both passed out on the couch and the back door is open. Violet, you're sure you know how to get in, right?
Yeah, of course I do. But if we can't find it, it shouldn't be too hard to climb over.
So, what's the plan? Literally just go in and look?
Pretty much. We could take some creepy photos, though. I think we'll be walking for, like, 20 minutes.
In the dark? Yeah. What did you expect?
Well, I knew we were walking in the dark. I guess I just underestimated how far the walk was.
And that's not really too far.
What time is it anyway?
It's close to midnight, but I had to make sure my parents were fully asleep. We have to go through the back sliding door, though. We have a ring camera in front, so we'll go to the sidewalk when we're far enough from the house.
Honestly, guys, I'm getting pretty nervous. I don't really know why I agreed. I guess I was just excited in the moment.
Dude, we already arranged the sleepover.
Do you just want to stay? It's fine if you do, just FaceTime us so we know where the break in the fence is.
I could, but I also don't want to sit here alone. It would be super awkward if your dad or mom randomly came in and it was just me.
Well, I think we're all going, so are you coming or not?
Let's just try not to be long, okay?
Alright, do you think you can all fit, or... It's a little tight, but I think you guys can make it.
Ow. You okay? Oh yeah, no worries. It's just a little bit sharp on the edges. Damn, Vi. Hard to believe your family sneaks in everywhere and you turned out the way you did. Oh, knock it off, Timothy. One thing is not gonna turn me into some criminal. My family doesn't really have that much money, but this tradition is extremely important to us. Plus, it's perfect. It's right behind an attraction.
I mean, it's sort of an odd tradition, going to a carnival every year.
So what? Tons of family members of mine have worked here over the years. It's been open since, like, the late 1800s.
No way! That's like 1,000 years.
No it isn't, dum-dum. It's over 100, but not 1,000.
Well, still super long for a carnival.
Tons of carnivals have been open for ages. I mean, my family has worked here for as long as I can remember.
Rad.
Yeah, cool, but I think we should go. Someone must be here.
Nah, don't worry. I'm sure it's, like, motion detected.
Wouldn't that, like, be a safety hazard?
Well, maybe a timer. I mean, it just hit 12 exactly.
Why would it be set on a timer? Especially at such a random hour. We really should get going. I mean, this doesn't feel like a good idea anymore.
Dude, it's been one full minute. Don't back out now.
I mean, I don't see anyone, and they wouldn't just turn the lights on to warn us. They'd just tell us not to trespass and make us leave.
I don't care. This is weird. We are going to get into major trouble even if no one is here. This is a big place. People in town will notice the lights and the music.
Aw, sick. There's an arcade over there. Move.
Bro.
And he's choosing the loudest thing in the place. Typical. Alright guys, look. If we see anyone, we'll leave. All we gotta do is pull the "we're just kids having fun near Halloween" card.
Well, let's just hope the cops are in a good mood, shall we?
Violet, wanna just go?
I do, but I don't think you and I are much use against someone who tries, like, jumping us on the streets. Not to be all "weak girl needs a man to protect her," but we're safer in a group. Let's just not stay long, please.
Something quieter? I'm sorry, I just really, really don't want to get caught.
Vi, I mean this in the nicest way possible, but no one is here. Why did you recommend this place if you were gonna be a buzzkill?
Oh my gosh, Timothy, why do you keep pressuring me and guilting me? People say stuff that they regret. I thought it would be fun in the moment, but now I'm nervous, okay?
Pressuring you? Violet, I just want to have a good time and... you're right. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry for yelling. And it's okay, it's just... If we get caught, I'm scared I'll be banned and I won't be able to attend with my family anymore. Are you sure you don't want to go? I mean, it's not going to be fun if you're on edge the whole time.
Ugh, someone take over for me. I'm just gonna go take a whiz and then we can leave, alright?
Why didn't you go before we left? You'd rather pee in a arcade carnival thingy bathroom?
I didn't have to go then. Timothy, take over.
I am awful at this game, but alright.
Can't be worse than me. I miss, like, every time. BRB.
Was that balloon there a second ago?
Someone has to be here. Ugh, why is this not working?
Ugh. That was quick.
Yeah, the bathroom was locked.
Are you okay?
Yeah, let's just get going.
Actually, I changed my mind. I just don't want to be long, like I said before.
What?
I mean,
no, we insist. If you're not comfortable, it's all right.
No, I insist. I think it could be fun.
Yeah, as long as you'll have fun.
Should we try getting on a ride? That would be awesome.
No! We can do anything else, but that would totally push it. Plus, with no operator, the rides aren't stopping. I really don't get it. Like, why are they even on?
It's like, really creepy.
Extra testing, I guess.
Yeah.
Vi, could you please take a photo of me in front of the Ferris wheel? It is so pretty.
And save evidence? No, thank you. You were all in on this a second ago, and the second before that, and before. What is happening?
I was, but the carnival shouldn't have just turned on. Plus, why did they all boot up all at the same time? That especially doesn't make sense. I'm sorry I've been so indecisive, but I'm extremely anxious.
No, that's called thrill. You're acting like there's a ghost here or something.
Not a ghost, Timothy. I feel like maybe they did start keeping night guards out, and he's messing with us instead of kicking us out. I don't know, but it doesn't feel right. I understand why you're worried, Violet, but that wouldn't make much sense. That'd be super unprofessional of them. Plus, you said yourself the ride shouldn't come on all at the same time, so how could a person doing that be any different?
I don't know why they all came on at the same time, but it doesn't feel right. And I'm not saying it's a ghost. I'm saying we're gonna get caught.
Just enjoy it. No one is messing with us. There has to be a reason they're on.
Exactly. If someone was here, one of us would have seen something by now.
Plus, this is so cool. Like, it's nice being here with some peace and quiet. You normally can barely hear the ride's music with everyone screaming.
And take a look at those animatronics. So flashy.
What animals even are those? They're so funny looking.
I think they're called humans. It's like some weird mythical creature. I don't know.
I wonder why they don't have real performers. I know they wouldn't be out right now, but that'd be a lot more interesting than some robots spinning around.
It's some kind of art piece. It's been here ever since I can remember. There used to be a real circus, but it ended up going out of business. I'm not sure why.
Yo, Isaac. Are you okay? You've been super quiet.
Yeah, sorry. I'm just a little bored, to be honest, since we can't go on anything.
We could start heading back.
We could probably go into the haunted funhouse. That's just a walkthrough, not a ride.
Yeah, but someone should be a lookout, and I don't want to stand out there alone, so not me.
Why would we need a lookout? Inside there, we're more concealed than standing out here.
Yeah, but if we walk out and there's a guard there or something, I don't know how we'd explain it.
If a guard does walk by, he's not gonna stand outside the funhouse. It'll be more obvious if one of us is standing out there.
Yeah, well, it just makes me feel a little better. I know it's not the smartest idea, but if I go in, I'll be anxious, and if I'm the only one standing out there alone, I'll be anxious.
Well, I'm not standing out there alone.
And I want to go in.
I guess I'll be lookout for now, and then when you three come out, me and Isaac can go in together, so that way none of you guys have to be alone.
Ugh. This is sort of creepy alone. Maybe I should have went in. Maybe I can still
catch up?
Actually, I should totally put this jester hat on and freak him out.
This is gonna be hilarious.
Ugh, any time now.
That was so lame.
Yeah.
Could have been better.
Wait, where's Timothy? Did he get caught?
Oh my god, I knew it was a bad idea to leave him! Oh my god!
You jerk!
Sorry. How was it?
Lame. I think there's supposed to be actors in there when it's actually open because there's not even animatronics in there.
Yeah, I've never checked out the funhouse, so I had no clue. But yeah, pretty empty.
Do 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 do.
What are you doing?
None of you even pointed out the hat.
Hat?
Yeah, it's a thing you, put on your head, cover bald spots, whatever you want to do with it.
Oh, cut it out. Don't mess with us.
No offense, dude, but invisible hat is kind of a lame joke.
Right back at ya. I found it on this tombstone thingy.
What? Are you sleep deprived? There's nothing on your head.
Ugh, whatever. I'm sorry for trying to make you laugh, I guess?
No, sorry, dude. I didn't mean it to come off rude. It just... that was a very random joke.
What time is it anyway? We've been here for like an hour, so probably around one.
Should we, get going now?
We didn't really do anything. Plus, I didn't go in the funhouse yet.
It was empty, remember?
All except for some creepy clown statue, but it was stationary, not like an animatronic or anything, so pretty boring.
Well, what is there really left to do? The only attraction we could go on was the funhouse.
We could jump onto the carousel. It's slow, so I don't think it'd be dangerous.
I said no rides.
We know. But this one goes like 3 miles per hour, if even. I think we'll be all right.
All right, but after that, we're getting out of here.
Just as I thought, she was lightening up a bit.
Yeah, but she's nervous. We should get going after this.
You're right. Let's go.
Wait. Come here.
Were these here a second ago?
Yeah. What do you mean? We had a whole conversation about it, remember?
About the bloody cards?
Cards? No, I mean the animatronics.
What's the holdup? I want to get going soon.
How are you not freaked out by this? It's gross.
Huh? What do you mean?
The cards, right there.
Jesus Christ, Nancy. Did you and Timothy work together to make up stupid pranks? It isn't very funny. I'm already worked up enough as it is.
No, we didn't, but I don't see anything either. Y'all really made fun of me for a quote-unquote invisible hat, but now you're saying there's invisible cards? After the carousel, I agree we should just go back. I am getting a little bit annoyed.
How do you not see them?
What?
It's okay. Some jokes don't land. Let's just go on the carousel.
Alright, Nancy. You're just imagining things. Just go have fun. I'm gonna catch up to you. Watch out!
Ugh, can this thing go any slower?
I actually like it. It's quite peaceful.
One picture, Violet, please!
Fine, but don't send it to anyone.
What?
Guys, get down here now!
Everything okay?
Just look at the photo! We're getting out of here now!
What do you mean? It's an adorable picture.
No, look in the background closer.
I don't see anything.
You don't see the clown? Let me see.
What? I'm telling you, he was right there behind you. It was probably just your reflection.
It wasn't my reflection. I don't look like a clown. I know what I saw.
I think it's time to head out. We're all on edge and we all keep arguing. I think it's for the best. Unfortunately, I agree. Let's head out.
I'm telling you, it was right there in the picture.
Guys, I'm sorry, but if this is some prank to make fun of my joke, it's really not that funny. It's just confusing. Actually, I am a little bit freaked out. The only time we've been separated was the fun house, so no one would have had time to make up a scheme to make fun of your joke. I was the only one out there, so that's probably when you came up with the idea.
You made the joke after we were done with the fun house, though. No one is trying to make fun of you.
I guess you guys have a point, but you could have always whispered something. Isaac, thank you for not taking part in their, nonsense.
About that. When we were in the arcade, I could have sworn I heard a balloon filling, and I saw it pop. I didn't say anything, because that was when we were originally going to leave, but then Violet changed her mind, and I had already said everything was okay, and I don't know, I should have said something there, but I didn't want to ruin anything.
I literally just thanked you for not making fun of me, man.
Dude, I'm not. Why do you think I came back from the bathroom so fast? I don't actually know if it was locked. I didn't even reach the bathroom.
What am I supposed to think? There's no such thing as ghosts, and no prankster security guard would be able to make us not see what the others are seeing.
I don't know if this is some elaborate prank or what, but let's just go to bed and then y'all can go home. I'll call you when I'm ready to hang out next.
It isn't a prank. Stop acting like we're so against your dumb joke. And honestly, I'm starting to believe your little hat thing. Like, you actually saw it. After what happened to me, at least.
We haven't had any time to scheme behind one another's backs, and I at least know I didn't come up with the blood-splattered cards. So unless you're all pranking me and got Timothy to act all offended to sell it, I feel something truly could be going on.
I for sure saw a balloon pop, no doubt about it. And I was so convinced I was wearing a silly hat. I just wanted to make you guys laugh.
And I didn't make up the clown. I'm fairly confident I could tell the difference between my face and a clown's face. It definitely was not my reflection.
So you guys promise it wasn't us just scheming against one another, right? Because I know I wasn't part of it.
Neither was I. I guess maybe something was going on. I'm really sorry for getting so offended.
Now that I think about it, Timothy, what did the hat look like? Because the clown I saw was wearing some weird puffed blue striped hat.
Yeah. So you guys are pranking me.
How would Violet know what it looked like if none of us saw it?
Because you probably did see it. That's how she knows. Timothy, calm down. You just apologized about being offended, and now you're doing it again.
Ugh, you're right, but this is just so freaking weird.
Let's just go to bed because I'm honestly a little scared right now. I believe y'all that it wasn't a prank, but I'd appreciate you telling me now if it was.
I know what I saw.
Have fun, buddy?
Yeah, Dad. It was pretty chill. Just, played some horror games and ate snacks. The usual.
How late were you kids up? You look exhausted.
Yeah, we didn't get much sleep. I'm gonna go take a nap if that's alright.
Get some rest. Your mom and I are gonna go to the store.
Longest night of my life. Huh? What the flip? Y-O-U. You? What?
Did you put a note in my closet to freak me
out?
I
found a note too. If this is a prank, I have no clue how the girls got it here. Your place is one thing since they stayed the night, but how here? It was under my pillow.
Just stop! This isn't funny.
I am not kidding.
I thought we agreed this wasn't a prank and to just put it behind us.
Well, what does yours say? Mine just says... must?
Mine says you.
You must. I think it stands for something.
Please, just stop with this prank, man.
This isn't a prank!
We have to call the girls. Please, man, this isn't a joke. And if it is, then Violet and Nancy are up to it together. I have no part of this. Even then, I don't think they are because of that balloon thing. No one followed me.
Yeah, true. They were with me the whole time.
You know what? Let's just call asking to meet up and bring the notes. They had to have gotten some too, right?
Then tuck this corner and perfect. And finally, nothing like a clean room to clear your mind. Hello?
Did you get a playing card with writing on it? Isaac and I just got one and I'm not sure what to do.
No, I did not get a note.
Look around, because I want to know if he's messing with me, because there was one in my closet, and he's the only one I know has one, so he's the only other reason I can imagine for having these notes.
I guess I can look around, but I just cleaned my room. I'm pretty sure I would have found it. The only other place I can imagine would be my dresser drawers, but... one sec. How did you get this here?
I didn't put it there! What does it say?
Oh, you know what it says. You planted it here.
Again, I didn't do it. How would I get it all the way to your house? If you're available, just come to my place. I'll call Violet, too, and we'll figure this out.
Okay. I'll be over soon. What the... Why is there paper on the stove? I could have just burned the whole house down. Well, whatever. Let's just get it off. Back? Whose is this? Oh crap, I have 2 missed calls from Timothy.
You must come back? What the tail does that mean?
You promise this isn't a joke, right?
No, Nancy, I am not joking.
You're honestly getting a little bit annoying about that.
Look, Timothy, I don't know how you could have gotten them to our houses anyway, but there has to be an explanation.
I am not going back there. I don't know what is going on, but I think we need to call the police. Whoever was stalking us out there is breaking and entering now.
You mean, kinda like we did?
Isaac, that is different, and you know it. This is our actual houses.
If we call the police and tell them what happened, we're the ones gonna be getting in trouble. There's no proof someone did this.
You're the one that keeps saying the cops will go easy on us.
Yeah, but if we already got away with it, I don't want to risk it.
We have to contact someone, Timothy.
I agree, Violet, but what are we supposed to say?
We all saw a vision and now there's magical notes that, from their point of view, could have easily been made up by one of us.
Well, there's gotta be paw prints on them or something, or test the blood that's on them.
Having someone else's blood on something in our possession would be a lot worse. I don't think we should do anything.
So what then? We're just gonna ignore all this?
I guess? I don't think the police will take us seriously, and I'm not about to tell my parents you two weren't even supposed to be over in the first place. And we all snuck out to break and enter.
I should we go back?
No! Are you crazy?
I don't think it's a person doing this, though. I think it's paranormal. It might be trying to tell us something.
I am not going back over a note like this. It sounds like there's someone waiting there to kill us.
So, we're just gonna see what happens next?
Well, I suppose. What else are we supposed to do?
They're gonna hide!
Go get your dad! What do I say? Well, he definitely already hears this, so go get him and turn off the alarm. I'll be right back.
Barnacle.
Dad, why aren't you turning that off? Son, stop your yelling. And turn what off?
The TV?
What? Not the show, Dad.
The fire alarm.
Oh, did I forget to change the batteries again?
What room?
Huh? It's not the battery sound, Dad. It's in every room.
What do you mean? All I hear is my show.
What do you mean you don't hear it? I can barely hear you.
What the?
Look, kid, your lack of sleep is starting to get to you. I might have to start cutting short on your sleepovers.
It's not my lack of sleep, Dad.
Maybe I just heard Mom's TV or something. So you have to scream over your mother's TV from all the way down here? Or did your friends put you up to this?
Yeah, it's a game of truth or dare. You got us. It's, my turn now.
All right, have fun. Just tone it down a little bit, okay?
Ugh, kids.
He, didn't hear it. I don't know how.
What do you mean he didn't hear? Oh my god.
And that does it. I'm officially terrified now.
This is definitely not someone pranking us. How would all four of us hear it, but not your dad?
What are we gonna do? This is getting really scary.
We must come back.
Well, go back.
No, 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 and no. We are not going back. If we don't, this will probably never end. Let's just go today, like during daylight, and bring some protection. Is everyone's phone charged in case we do need to call someone? Even if they think we're crazy, it's better to be crazy and safe than sane and dead.
I am not going. We are not going.
Fine, we are not. You can stay, but us three are.
I don't know what he or it, whatever it wants, but if it can torment us here, it probably will never stop. I'll tell my dad we're going out to lunch and we'll be back in a couple hours. If we take too long, we'll try another time.
Are you sure we should be here in broad daylight? People are walking on the sidewalk. And was that gas canister really necessary? I can't believe we couldn't talk you out of that.
Just wait until no one is in view. I do not want this to be in the dark again. And if this is really a ghost, fire is the cliche way to get rid of it, right?
Or fire powers it. I mean, think about it. All the tricks it's been doing have been fire-themed. Your cards lighting on fire, Violet finding hers on the stove, and of course the fire alarms.
Fire isn't powering it. What are we supposed to do? Stab a ghost?
Let's just go in.
So, I guess let's just start walking.
Isaac, where did you see the balloon? Let's start there. I don't really know what we're intending on doing, but it's a start.
It was near the arcade bathroom, next to all the plushies and the cotton candy stand.
I was right here, and the balloon started filling up, and it popped, and I wasn't even near it.
Well, nothing's happening now, so I guess try the funhouse?
This theory is terrifying regardless, because it still means someone broke into our houses, but maybe it is some sort of prank from a guard trying to scare us away, instead of a ghost?
Yeah, because that explains the magical fire alarm and the mystical burning papers. Not to mention our visions.
Well, maybe it only works at night?
That only happens in fairy tales.
I wouldn't exactly call this a fairy tale.
I'm starting to think there's not going to be any more episodes of Popular. Stinks.
What the heck?
I just want to relax today. Oh my god. No, I am not doing this today. Just take a deep breath.
Oh, figures nothing's happening. This is where we walked in regardless.
Personally, I'd rather nothing happen.
But there has to be a reason we're here.
And the animatronic circus is behind us, and I don't see cards this time.
Hold on, Violet's calling.
What's up?
I got another note and, my mirror and...
Calm down, Violet. It's alright. What does it say?
It says you guys need me, but I don't want to go back. What do I do? What do I do?
Just stay home for now. We're trying to figure this out.
Please, just be safe.
We will. Just breathe. They need you. You can't let them get hurt. What? You're coming now? But it's getting dark and...
I know, but it keeps tormenting us. If I don't come now, it's gonna keep happening tomorrow and the next day and the next day. I don't care if it's light or dark. I just want this over now.
I understand. Just drive safe. We'll be waiting.
Of all things, you brought a butter knife? Well, what else was I supposed to grab? At least I didn't bring an entire tank of gas. I don't think a butter knife would even hurt a fly. Well, guys, what's the plan?
Honestly, I'm not really sure. I guess just to stick together, I suppose.
We've already been here for an hour. Why is nothing happening? Especially now that all four of us are here. Personally, I'm glad nothing is happening.
Maybe it's over somehow? I don't understand why it wants us back here so bad if nothing's gonna happen. We just got nudged to come back earlier.
Well, we were here during the night.
We could just wait. It should be dark out in, like, an hour.
Our parents just thought we were going out to eat, remember?
But why would it want us here now if it only comes out at night? It didn't say when, so I guess for some reason it assumed we would come back at night. I see where you guys are coming from, but isn't the whole night thing just a movie trope? A lot of horror movies get their paranormal aspects from real-world mythology. Maybe if ghosts exist, there is some truth to it.
If ghosts exist? Timothy, were you here last night?
Har har, very funny, but you get my point.
Well, either way, we can't stay past sundown. If you guys want, we could discuss over a late dinner, just like fast food or something so our parents don't start calling us.
Even if it is some kind of nightly presence, how come the notes are showing up during the day?
That is a good point, but why would it want us back there in the first place if nothing was gonna happen?
Maybe it just doesn't want to show itself during broad daylight.
Well, if you think about it, it hasn't really shown itself at all. It just gave us visions while we were there. The only time it showed itself was in Violet's photo.
Wait, Violet, the mirror reflection that you mentioned in the photo, they were both clowns, right? What about the statue that was in the funhouse?
What if it wasn't really a statue? Thank you very much, ma'am.
Anytime. And pardon me for overstepping, but I couldn't help but overhear. Are you guys talking about spirits?
Sorta, I guess.
I actually study the paranormal. I know, call me crazy, a witch, blah blah blah, I've heard it all. But I may be able to give you some advice. Is this for some story you're writing, or truth?
Yeah. It's something that's been...
A story we're writing. We're trying to figure out why our ghost character would lead us, the characters, back to the haunt and not reveal itself when it did before. It first appeared at night, but they had occurrences during the day at their houses, like, away from the initial sighting.
Well, it's actually just a misconception that spirits are only at night. They can be active at any point in the day or night. Spirits were alive at some point, too. They have preferences, just like you and I. Tell me more about your ghost character. He's a clown or jester of some sort. That's pretty much all we know or have so far.
Ah, I see. Well, clowns and jesters like to play jokes. Maybe for your character it could be some sort of scary game, only wanting to mess with others at night to make it more of a thrill.
So, in other words, you're saying the clown could be like
able to come out at any point of the day, but he just wants to mess with them.
Pretty much, yeah. And I'm sorry to cut this short, but I have more tables to tend to, so I hope this helped. Hope to see you kids again.
Well, I suppose that makes sense, but why did you tell her you're writing a story? Some plotline she pulled out of her tale probably isn't fact.
We don't know her. If we told her what happened, she could rat us out for breaking in.
I get that, but we wouldn't even have to mention that part to her. Plus, she said she studies the paranormal. She could have actually helped.
Maybe she did help. Even if she was coming from a storytelling point of view, I'm sure what she said about ghosts having preferences has some sort of honesty. Spirits were pets too. They're literally the spirits of the deceased.
So we're just supposed to follow the supposed rules of this clown's game?
I know it's silly, but what else are we gonna do? We were stuck, and this is an answer. A stretch of an answer, but a start nonetheless.
Just so I'm clear, whether anything happens or not, this is the last time I'm sneaking out.
Same. I feel like I'm on the verge of getting caught.
Well, show yourself!
Ugh, this is so stupid.
I take it back. You know what? Screw this!
Isaac!
Wait up!
What the hell? How are we back here?
Am I imagining things?
How on earth did we show up back here?
Am I going crazy?
I've never been more confused in my life. I know this sounds crazy, but maybe we should split up. If it keeps bringing us back here, it's just gonna kill all of us at once. But if we hide, maybe it can't find us.
No, that is crazy.
Well, we apparently can't leave, so we might as well try anything. Everyone, just go. No, I am not running.
Okay. Where do I go?
There's nowhere to hide. What the hell?
Oh my god.
This is just comedic at this point.
Okay, I'll just tuck myself behind here.
Tell me.
Guys!
Ugh, why is it always the damn hat? You're not scary!
Okay, that's a little scary.
Ugh! Crap, dude, I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Look behind you.
Guys!
Where's Violet? I saw the clown, and it's looking for her specifically.
What?
Why her?
Bobby!
I know you're in there.
One little bunny jumping on the bed. She fell off and bumped her head.
Guys, the big top. I hear noise over there. Let's go. God, I can't believe I left these.
Violet, can you hear us?
Oh, thank God you guys are back.
Get out! What do you want from us?
For people to know the truth.
Away!
Oh, you fools! You can't kill who's already dead.
Now's our chance, while it's distracted.
But Violet!
When we get out of here, we'll call the police, but we can't stay.
Where on earth were you kids?
I'm so sorry, Mom and Dad. We snuck into the carnival down the street and we don't think Violet made it.
Didn't make it? What on earth are you talking about?
There was a ghost. Not literally a ghost.
He meant like a ghostly looking killer.
Is she hurt? Stop joking with us.
No! Why does everyone always think I'm joking? Mom, call the cops. Do you think she'll be okay? No, Nancy, she won't be okay. Didn't you see her body? It was burnt to a crisp. Even if she somehow wakes up, she won't be okay, and she's not going to wake up.
Burnt to a crisp? What the hell happened?
Oh my God. Okay, I'm gonna call everyone's parents and the cops. Is there anything else you need to tell us?
We all split up and thought he was burned up by the big
cop. Everyone, one at a time. I can't understand you. You, son, what's your name?
I'm Timothy. A couple nights ago, we snuck into the fall fair, festival. There was this clown, and it was, I think it was a ghost, but I don't know.
What? You told me it was a ghostly killer, not a literal ghost.
Dad, I don't know what it was. Violet showed us an easy way to get in, and we thought we were just gonna walk through the park and go back home. But suddenly the entire carnival lit up, and Violet just wanted to go home. But we just wanted to stay. After some time, things started happening that we can't explain.
I know this is scary, son, but there's no such thing as ghosts. Can you just tell the cops what happened?
We I know that sounds crazy, but we weren't alone, but we were. I don't know how to explain this without sounding insane. I heard balloons filling and popping right away, and at first I thought someone like a worker was messing with us, but I didn't see anyone. We all saw things, and Violet said she saw a clown, and then these notes on cards started showing up, and we had more visions, like, trying to force us to go back.
Ghost clowns? Visions? Notes? Well, can we see some of these notes?
No, I mean I would, but they all disappeared. I don't know where they went.
What really happened? I don't mean to be the bad guy here, but this is insane.
Ma'am, I know it doesn't make sense. We know that. But you have to believe us. We were attacked.
It's okay, kiddo. We're listening. So you mentioned visions. What were these like?
Okay. Well, like I said, the balloons. Timothy kept seeing a hat. God, this sounds so stupid saying it out loud. I saw random cards that I know for a fact weren't there before. And then Violet claimed to have seen the clown in a photo that I asked her to take of me. But none of us saw it in the photo, and we didn't take her seriously.
So she's the only one who saw the clown, and she's coincidentally the one who's not here?
No. It's not like that. We all saw it when we went back.
You kids went back a second time?
Technically three times.
Is the body still there?
Yes. She should be.
Why on earth wouldn't you kids call the police when it happened instead of running home?
We'll figure that out later. The other parents are walking up. Let's all go talk to them.
You better radio some officers and fill them in on where they need to go. I'll go chat with the other families.
This is Officer Jules. I need a team to meet up at the Fall Festival. This could be a potential murder cover-up. The kids were talking about ghosts and clowns. Story didn't add up. The body should be at the Fall Festival. Find it and gather evidence. Over.
This poor kid.
Those burns are so severe. Why wouldn't they get rid of the evidence?
I couldn't tell ya. We're gonna have to take these in for prints. Are you able to tell me why this was found at the scene of your friend's burned body with your paw prints all over it?
It was for self-defense, sir.
And who are you defending yourself against? Your friend?
No, of course not. She's a sweet person. I was defending myself from that clown we've all been mentioning.
Timothy, this is a serious matter. I need you to tell me the truth now. Your friends are currently in an investigation, but you are the main suspect for the murder of Violet Hughes.
Look, I know how bad this looks, but it wasn't us. We already told you. We snuck in, which is fair for a charge, but we did not hurt her. We kept, spawning in different areas, so none of us were together at the time. When we found her, the tent was in flames, and we found her like that.
Spawning? As in, a video game? There was no damage done to the tent. It looks like someone had poured gas on her and lit a match, both of which have your prints on them. The tent was never in flames. At least there is no evidence of that.
Officer, I understand why you don't believe me, but this is what happened. I don't know what else I can tell you.
I'm gonna need you to calm down. Right now, we're trying to get to the bottom of things. There are no signs of ghosts or murderers aside from the evidence that traces back to you. Your friends may be charged as accomplices, but with no real evidence, they may be let off the hook. Which, in my opinion, is unfair, and they should be charged as such. But I cannot legally do anything without evidence. But these prints, Timothy, they are very clearly linked back to you. As such, we need a confession. If you can provide that for us, we can lessen your sentence, seeing as you're a minor.
My sentence?
Well, you still need to go through court, of course. But I'd say it's safe to assume you'll be heavily charged.
No! This isn't right! This clown was tormenting us!
A ghost clown was not tormenting you. Do you even understand how ridiculous this sounds?
What kind of cop are you? Your job isn't to demean me, it's to interview me.
I am not trying to demean you. I'm just trying to show you how this sounds in the case of law. All evidence points back at you. Breaking and entering, arson, and attempted murder.
Wait, attempted? Is Violet okay?
My sweet girl, please wake up. What did those terrible kids do to you?
We're gonna do anything we can to serve you justice.
Don't worry, sweetie. Those monsters are gonna pay for what they did to you.
Timothy Grayson has been charged with the attempted murder of Violet Hughes. To this charge, Timothy Grayson has entered a plea of not guilty. You may call your first witness.
I request that my friend, Isaac Sanders, speaks first.
Oh God. Pardon me. I've never done this before, so I don't really know what to say.
Is it true that Timothy pressured Violet to join when you all broke and entered into the carnival?
Well, technically, yes. But she had the idea first. She just got nervous when we arrived.
Do you, Isaac, have any say as to why his prints were on the potential murder weapon?
It truly was used for self-defense.
Mr. Sanders, with what it appears, it was not used for self-defense. Nancy, please come up to the stand.
Yes, Your Honor.
Violet Hughes was left in a coma that could be indefinite. What evidence do you have for or against Timothy?
We've all been close for so long.
It's all just coincidental.
I will fight day and night as long as I live.
I don't think my son would do this, but I...
All cases point back to Timothy, and there's nothing...
They claim it was all her idea, but I refuse to believe that. She's always been so good.
We have hereby determined Timothy Grayson as guilty. He will be receiving 15 years jail time. As for Nancy and Isaac, there is no way to prove your affiliation to the crime. You may go home with your parents.
Hello, this is Teresa with Rookie LPS News. Local teens were accused of the attempted murder of 17-year-old Violet Hughes. One teenager by the name Timothy Grayson has been arrested as of Saturday evening. Police say there were three students on the site of the crime. Their names are not yet to be publicized, but are not able to be prosecuted due to lack of evidence of their involvement. Many claim to be outraged at this fact, saying it's unfair and all parties should be retried. The teenagers have claimed to see delusions of a clown, but no further evidence supports this claim. Police are still investigating, and the fall park will more than likely be closed this year.
Rise and shine, Buttercup. Your family is here to see you.
How come they won't believe me anyway?
They called in for visitation. They'd like to speak with you. You gotta stick by me, though, alright?
Of course, sir. I understand.
Timothy, why?
I swear, I didn't do it, you guys!
Timothy, we want to believe you, but what are we supposed to think?
I don't know. You just have to believe me, okay? Why would I ever hurt one of my best friends? There was a ghost, I swear to you.
Again with the ghost bullcrap? Enough. I don't believe you're a murderer, to be honest, son. But you know what really happened, and it ain't no ghost. You know what's going on here, and I expect you to come out with the truth. Do you even realize that they're already debating on moving you to a mental facility? If you keep this up, they're gonna finalize that decision.
What do you mean, a mental facility?
And not to even mention, your other friends may be getting involved again soon, too. Violet's family is trying to press charge against all of us and the police department for being negligent and not giving them charges in the first place.
But they had nothing to do with it. None of us were anywhere near her when it happened. I don't know what to do. I didn't hurt her, and even if I had, they had nothing to do with it.
Oh man, you heard what's about to happen, right? Involving the parents of that kid Violet? Yeah. I mean, I get it, but I don't want to lose my job. Right. They're demanding we charge the two other kids and that it was unjust treatment and bias due to them being teenagers. But us, nor the judge, make the laws. Sure, they were there at the scene of the crime, but there was no way to prove that they were accomplices. And look, I have kids myself, and I understand where they're coming from. There is literally nothing we can do about it. The kids all admitted to being there, but without hard evidence, we can't send them anywhere. Well, there is a chance. We just have to keep fighting so we can get those other two prosecuted. It's not fair that they can walk the streets.
I believe all parties are guilty, including Nancy and Isaac. My reason being, they were clearly there the night it happened. Why would they be defending Timothy?
It does not take three pots to hold up a gas canister, hence why I think his paw prints were the only ones visible on the weapon.
There is no such thing as ghosts. Blaming something on a spirit is crazy. If you kids were a parent, you would understand why we are trying so hard to find her justice.
Where am I?
Everyone, stop! Oh my goodness, baby! Give me a hug!
Ow! Oh dear, I'm so sorry.
Oh, I am so grateful you're okay. How did you get here?
Sir, we tried calling you guys, but you must not have noticed due to being here. We questioned her and finally confirmed their stories. Although, we are still looking for a true suspect because the ghost thing still does not make sense.
Timothy, I am so sorry you got arrested because I couldn't say anything. And Nancy and Isaac, I am so sorry that you almost got in trouble too.
Why on earth would we be mad at you? I am so glad you're okay.
We thought we were gonna lose you.
Please, don't scare us like that again.
If I get permission from my parents, I would like to cancel this trial. Timothy, Nancy, and Isaac are all innocent. Oh, Violet, honey, I am so sorry about what happened to you, and thank you for coming all this way to make sure our kids were cleared as innocent. It truly means the world. Mrs. Grayson, I am so sorry for accusing your son and the other kids.
If any other parent was in your shoes, they'd do the same. I'm just glad this was all a big misunderstanding.
But we still need to find the true culprit of who did this.
That won't be easy. I hope you all can believe it coming from me, but this creature was otherworldly.
I hate to be this person, and I know you kids believe this is some sort of entity, but whatever you think you saw has to be a real person. As scary as clowns can be, they're just people wearing makeup.
Yeah, but he kept reappearing and making us see things.
A professional entertainer could make anything seem real.
No, this wasn't some magic hobbyist.
I know you're all scared and under a lot of pressure, and I'm so glad that you're okay. But this was traumatic to you. Your minds may be twisting things up. We believe there was a clown, okay? Just not an entity. Timothy, you said something about a hat last time you were in. Can you give us a description of it and we can attempt to find a store who sells them and pull up the most recent receipts?
Yeah, of course. It was purple and blue with stripes. And it had, purple pom-poms on the top. It had 2 points, not just one.
How about his makeup? Many clowns trademark their looks. Odds are he isn't a real clown, but we should look into it nonetheless. Well, it was super smudged. He had rosy cheeks and a red nose, so pretty basic.
His rosy cheeks were kind of like heart-shaped. It was a little hard to tell, though.
Also, I believe he was wearing purple contact lenses.
I see. It sounds like some kind of wild card wannabe.
Wild what?
Oh, nothing. I shouldn't be throwing things out there just yet. Did he perhaps have blue streaks going down his eyes, though?
They were more black, but yeah. How do you know about that, if you don't mind me asking?
We cannot disclose any information yet, but we may already have some clues.
Thank you for having all of us and the kids over. It's so sweet of you after all that's happened.
I've been praying for your little girl's recovery. I am so, so sorry about what happened.
It's the least we can do after getting everyone wrongly involved with this. And with Violet, she should be making a full recovery. She will have a lot of scarring, though, unfortunately.
I just hope they're doing okay up there.
How have you been feeling? You look so awful.
It's been hard. I'm still in a lot of pain, and after waking up, I don't feel like I'm all here. It's like I'm constantly in a dream state, even though I'm conscious.
I know this can't compare to what you're going through, but we've been heartbroken. We had no clue if you'd make it, and now, with Timothy's name being blown up around town, I can't even imagine what his image is gonna be like now. Ugh, I shouldn't make this about us. I'm just glad you're sorta okay.
Yeah, it stinks, but this isn't about me. We're just glad you're alright.
I don't mean to change the topic, but has anyone else been thinking about that name they mentioned?
Name? What do you mean?
A fool's card or whatever?
I've been thinking about it a lot too. The name was wild card though, not fool's card. Maybe Google it. Is anything popping up?
Not really, no. I don't see anything. Try wild card fall festival.
That's true.
Oh damn! I think I found it, but he looks a little different.
Here, take a look. Wildcard the Clown was an amusement entertainer who traveled across states with the famous Paw Brothers Circus. He was best known for his magic tricks and illusions. Well, I guess the cops got something right. Children of all ages loved his shows, and people would go to their local fairs just to see his amazing acts. He was said to have magnificent humor and great showman abilities. He invented many of his own card tricks that are still used to this day. In the late fall of 1892, the annual Fall Festival had the popular Big Top Circus attraction showcase, just like every year, later to be replaced with the well-known animatronic show we know of today.
Oh wow.
Russell Johnson, better known as Wild Card, was working on set when a coworker, Jeanette Hughes, accidentally set the curtain on fire while practicing her baton spinning backstage before her premiere.
Jeanette Hughes? Do you know who this is, Violet, or is it a coincidence?
I've never heard of her, but generations of my family have worked there. But this is a traveling event.
I guess I'll continue reading and we can possibly figure more out. At this time, Wildcard was changing into his costume. He was found deceased with severe burns. Investigators believe his costume restrained him from finding safety due to him being found with it only partially on his front legs. He could not get in or out of the costume on time with it being wrapped around his front legs. Three members were severely injured, while nine were unharmed. But Russell was declared dead at the age of 35. Jeanette Hughes was charged with manslaughter and showed a great deal of remorse, quoting, "I normally only practice with unlit batons, but I couldn't master my new act without the accuracy. I should have checked my surroundings or made do with what I had." That's about it. I don't see any image of her though, and it doesn't say if she's a rabbit or not.
Violet, do you think you should ask your parents about Jeanette?
Maybe, but where will that get us? They don't believe that Wildcard is a spirit, and the cops already mentioned that they think it's a wannabe of Wildcard, so just someone cosplaying in a way.
But this would explain so much. Why, for some reason, nothing else happened to us three after he struck you.
And when the carnival lit up, it was immediately after you mentioned your family working there. Think about it.
I guess we could show them. I mean, we already look crazy as it is. Come in.
Hey, sweetie. I don't know if this is a good time, but we just got a call.
Wait, can we show you something first? I think it might lead to who attacked me.
That's the thing, hon. We got justice. Your attacker, he was found.
What? How did they get him?
But how? We just found this article. It shows that he was killed years ago.
Yes, honey. We know about the copycat that dresses like him. It's sick.
But what about everything we saw? It still doesn't explain that.
And, are we related to Jeanette Hughes?
Ugh,
Yes, we are. But it's just all a big coincidence. I'm so sorry that you found that article. It must be so hard for you to read right now.
That is a stretch of a coincidence though, Dad. Why would he only hurt me? I don't know. It's a crazy coincidence, but it's just that, a coincidence. You just happened to be there at the wrong time. Disgusting that a copycat of Wildcard would be lingering around there, but that's all it could be.
But our visions and...
Well, the real Wildcard was an illusionist. Even if he was just a copycat, he may have practiced. I know it's crazy to imagine, but it can't be a ghost.
But I...
He's definitely a...
I am happy to see you get justice. Truly.
You have the right to remain silent.